No, you got to pack your toilet paper when you're going to Vegas.
Welcome into this edition of Charger Basketball here on UAHChargers.com. We will pause for the national anthem, then roll through the starting lineups here this Saturday afternoon. By the UIH Pep Band. Let's see if we can't hear from Paul Tranquillo, the PA announcer for today's starting lineups. So if I'm having a hard time hear it, I'm imagining you're having a hard time hear it because I'm half deaf. Let's roll through the starting lineups. First up for the Lady Buccaneers under head coach Sarah Condren. As the Buccaneers come in 7-11 in GSC play, 10-13 overall. They will start Rachel Lee, a senior from Jackson, Tennessee, from Jackson Christian School. Number 11, Kinsey Jones, a senior from Park Hills, Missouri. Number 22, Byron Lytle, a sophomore from Jackson, Tennessee. Lauren Taylor, a freshman out of Colliersville, Tennessee, from Colliersville High School. And number 34, Michaela Incas, a senior out of Findlay, Tennessee. Now for the UAH Chargers, and this is a biggie. This game is big for both the men and women here this Saturday afternoon. We will counter with number 3, Aaron Sanders, a junior out of Signal Mountain, Tennessee. Number 4, Morgan Tipton, a senior from Huntsville, Alabama, from Buckhorn High School. Of course, it is senior day. Number 5, Bailey Johnson, getting the start as well, a senior out of Coleman, Alabama. She's a member of the 1,000 Point Club for these ladies. Number 21, Allie Bolton, a senior out of Smyrna, Tennessee. And number 23, Heidi Miller, a senior from Sarasota, Florida. Chargers come in 5-5 on their home schedule here at home. And overall, conference-wise, it's a 10-8 season for Coach Andrea Lemon's team. Union, West Florida, Lee, Valdosta State, and Delta State have clinched spots in the Gulf South Conference basketball tournament. Right outside is UAH, West Georgia, and Montevallo, and West Alabama. So today, and next Thursday for that matter, in Carrollton, loom large in the last two games of the regular season. 10 minutes is up on the clock. Here we go with our first game here this afternoon. Nice crowd already on hand, but feel free to step on into the stable. Buccaneer basketball, little floater in the lane is no good, and a loose ball foul to UAH. And that foul, Enos with her first foul, team's first foul, so Here comes the Chargers with our first possession in a scoreless game here early on in quarter number one. Three ball in the corners, no good for Bailey, and rebound is loose, taken out by Heidi Miller. Hands it over to Bailey, kick it over to Sanders. Miller holds it high, starts off the play call with 20 on the shot clock. Miller looking down low, skips it over. That's Sanders who resets it. 10 on the shot clock. Sanders again with it. 8 on the shot clock. Loses the handle, down on her knee, and stolen away by Christian Brothers. To the other end goes Taylor. She lays it up, no good. Rebounded by Miller, and Taylor is slow to get up, and she's hobbling on her way back. Bailey attacks the lane, misses the layup, and rebounded by the Buccaneers. We are scoreless here early on between CBU and UAH. Dribbling it out, Lee. Moves it around the arc. Now Taylor at the free throw line, kicks it up top of the key to Jones. Back to Taylor. 5 on the shot clock. Taylor ends up with it with 1 on the shot clock, and she missed it badly. That's a 30-second shot clock violation and turned over to UIH. Neither team registered a point yet so far in this one, as we are scoreless so far, 2 minutes into this opening quarter. Sanders left open, makes that 3 in the corner. Aaron Sanders, the junior from Signal Mountain, Tennessee. I had to break the unenviable news to her that the Vols lost to LSU in overtime, 82-80, and she said that hurts. 3-0, your score. Chargers with the basketball and a 3-point lead. Holding it, right wing is Allie Bolton. Now tipped in for a 3-ball, no good. Rebounded by Miller. Miller kicks it back out to Aaron Sanders with a fresh shot clock. So far, one bucket has been made collectively. And that bucket made by Aaron Sanders is forcing the pass down below and stealing it away as Jones to the other end for CBU. Nice passing underneath, and the layup is up and good. That time for Lytle. It's a 3-2 Charger lead 3 minutes into this opening quarter. Bolton holds it on the left wing, resets it, and it's nearly stolen away, is stolen away by CBU. Bounce pass underneath. Incas lays it up and in. CBU grabs a 1-point lead here on the road at 4-3. Bailey Johnson fires it over to Sanders into the near corner to Bolton. Bolton looking for Morgan Tipton, but she's covered up underneath. Sanders attacks the elbow, kicks it into the corner. That's Bailey's floater. Too hard off the glass. Rebounded by Miller, who lays it up and in. Heidi Miller, the senior from Sarasota, Florida, with her first bucket of the game, gives the Chargers a 1-point lead here in this first quarter. It's 5-4. 3-ball, top of the key, no good for CBU, and rebounded by Aaron Sanders. Sanders just plays with a tiger in her tank. Down low it goes. Tipton scoops it, lays it up and in with the left hand. Morgan Tipton makes it a 3-point Charger lead at 7-4. Game so vital for the standings to earn a spot in the Gulf South Conference basketball tournament for UIH. The 3-ball there for Rachel Lee is good on the top of the key, and we're tied at 7 apiece. Holding it, Bolton finds Tipton in the near corner. Skips it over left wing. Now Bailey, an open 3-ball. Is good for Bailey Johnson. Her first made bucket of the game. And that is 2 early 3-balls for UIH. 10-7 your score. Near steal, open 3, look as an air ball. And out of play to UIH. 5:06 left to go here in this first quarter of play. Sanders brings it up. That's Miller with it. Man-to-man defense. Driving it, Miller. They left her wide open. She lays it up and in and made her pay. Heidi Miller, that was a zone defense. That was not a man-to-man. My mistake. 12-7 your score in favor of the Chargers. Driving it and fouling on her way up. There was Adkins. She'll get some free throws. A timeout here on the floor. And for the Chargers here out of the gate, it is a 12-7 lead. Now a quick word from Blue Cross Blue Shield of Alabama and Bojangles.
In Alabama, sports matter. They break down barriers and bring people together. Sports help make us who we are. It's in our blood, our culture, and our hearts. Because your team isn't just your team, it's your family. And that's why Blue Cross is a proud sponsor of athletic programs across the state. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama. We cover what matters.
Ever have one of those days when nothing seems to go your way? Maybe instead of that sad breakfast bar you ate this morning, you should have started your day off right with a made-from-scratch breakfast biscuit from Bojangles. Don't worry, it's never too late to restart your day at Bojangles. Our delicious breakfast biscuits are served for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, so you can get your day back on track anytime. Go ahead, come into Bojangles and restart your day with two country ham biscuits for just $3.69. Bojangles, it's bow time.
97.7, The Zone.
12-7, your score. CBU will head to the free throw line for their first free throw attempt of the game. Front end rattles in for Adkins, Kelsey Adkins, sophomore out of Lawrenceburg, Tennessee. Second free throw, rims out, no good. Rebounded by UAH. It's a 12-8 Charger lead here in quarter number one. 4.5 minutes to go. Johnson, another open three. Another open make for Bailey Johnson. Her second made three of this opening quarter. And it's a 15-8 lead now for the Chargers. That is our third made three of this opening quarter. Buccaneer basketball. Adkins wants that basketball, shoots it and misses it on the top of the key. Long rebound stays in CBU's possession with a fresh shot clock. We are 6 of 10 out of the floor. CBU is 3 of 9. Another shot and another miss for Christian Brothers, but another rebound as well for CBU. Another open three ball and rimmed out as Tipton was fouled underneath by Adkins. That is the second team foul for the Buccaneers. Charger basketball, that's Sanders with it, drives it into the free throw line. Bailey, another three. Another make for Bailey Johnson. The senior from Coleman is red hot here to start this game. It's an 18-8 advantage for UAH. Atkins moves it to the right wing. A long three is no good. Rebounded by Allie Bolton. Chargers will rush it up with Bailey Johnson. Drives it, kicks it to Sanders, and an open three for Sanders is good. Erin Sanders, her second made three for the junior from Signal Mountain, Tennessee. UAH, we are now 5 of 7 from beyond the arc to start this game. Open three in the corner for CBU, rims out, but rebounded by CBU. It's a 21-8 Charger lead. Baseline layup, no good. Ball rebounded by Bailey Johnson. So this is a 9-0 run for the Chargers in the last 2:08. Bailey keeps it into play. Sends it over to Miller. Down low to Tipton. Powers her way up, and she's bumped on her way up, I think, by Lee. It is on Lee, her first, team's third. Tipped into the free throw line. Senior day here for both the men and women. Last game of the regular season here in the friendly confines. Tipton misses the front end of the free throws. Katie Spiegel set to check in after this potential free throw, should Morgan make it. Second free throw is no good. CBU basketball trailing at 21-8. 13-point lead here is the largest lead of the game. Of course, we just started. And CBU's on a bit of a drought. Bounce pass underneath. Blocked away by Tipton. Went right to Bailey Johnson. Bailey back with it. Skips it in the corner. Aaron drives the baseline. Lays it up and no good. And rebounded by CBU. Boy. Driving it back the other direction. A reverse layup is no good there for CBU, as they have now been scoreless for CBU for the last 3:05 and counting. Miller sends it down low to Tipton. Mo back to the bucket, powers her way up, lays it up and in. 4 first quarter points for Morgan Tipton. A foul on Bailey Johnson. Minute 13 left to go here in quarter number one. As place is starting to fill up a little bit. A rather large, looming NCAA conference region game, I should say. And not only affecting the Gulf South, but the South regional rankings as well for the men's game. Atkins ends up with it. Her three ball rims in. Atkins' first made bucket of the game. Cuts it to a 12-point lead for the Chargers at 23-11. Payne holds her dribble, skips it over to Miller. Open three ball. Rattles in for Heidi Miller. Her third made bucket of the opening quarter. Lead grows back up to 15. Largest lead of the game. Atkins bounces it to the elbow. Pivoting around there is Taylor. Kick it back out for a three ball. No good as it doinks off the front of the rim. 18 seconds to go in the quarter. Spiegel back to Bailey. Bailey thought about a three. Why not? Shoot it, girl. You've made three of them already. Sanders with 5 seconds. Sanders pivots. Finds Emmeline at the buzzer. No good. And that'll do it. Quarter number one is in the books, and the Chargers lead it by 15. It's 26-11 here on the campus of UAH, and what is Senior Day?
This is Wes Neighbors talking to Chris Haygood of Bob Wallace Appliance. Chris, what sets you apart from other appliance dealerships?
Wes, these appliances are going into the most used room in your house, your kitchen. The way we have these appliances displayed, it's easy for you to visualize how they'll look in your home. Wes, what sets us apart is the people. They're well-trained. In fact, they live and breathe these appliances. And if you need service, you'll really appreciate our parts department.
Contact Bob Wallace Appliance at 256-533-2121.
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there, Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7 The Zone.
10 more minutes up on the clock. It is a 15-point advantage for the Chargers at 26-11. We were 10 of 16 from the floor for 65%. 6 of 9 from beyond the arc. Christian Brothers shot 22% in that opening quarter. They were 4 of 18, 2 of 11 from beyond the arc. 1 of 2 at the free throw line. Incidentally, UAH was 0 of 2 at the free throw line. Spiegel down on the baseline to start the second quarter. Bailey, open three. Rims out. Rebounded, though, by Katie. One dribble and loses possession. You'll find that play right there is a learning play for all five position players. Let that height be your advantage. The minute you put the ball on the floor, you let the smallest guy or gal equal to your height. Buccaneer basketball. Lee sends it over left wing to Lytle. Whistle away from the basketball and an offensive foul, I assume, on an illegal screen. Honestly, did not see it. Paying more attention to the basketball more than anything. Lee ends up with the foul. That's her second foul. We're in quarter number two on senior day here on campus here at UAH. Spiegel down low, powers her way up, and that's an offensive foul. The left elbow right there is what caused that foul. If she were just to go straight up and not lead with the elbow, that whistle would have not blown. But the lead remains 15 for the Chargers at 26-11. Dribbling it out is Jones. Man-to-man defense for UAH. Into the near corner it goes to Taylor. Jones drives it. Her floater high off the glass, no good. Stick by, blocked away by Katie Spiegel. And then she gets fouled underneath on a reach-in foul, I assume, on Jones. And that is a foul on Jones. So neither team has scored so far here in quarter number two. It's a 26-11 lead for UIH. Spiegel fouled underneath. Regular season ends in the Gulf South Conference next Thursday in Carrollton, Georgia, for both the men and women. Inbounds it goes with a fresh shot clock for UAH. Payne dribbles it out. Ends up in the hands of Harris for an open three ball. Misses it as it volleyballs over to Katie, who lays it up and in. Katie Spiegel off the dribble, lays up off the glass. It's a 28-11 advantage now for UAH. 8 minutes left to go before halftime. A long three ball is no good as it pops out. Stays in CBU's hands. Another three ball is good, this time by Lytle. Her second made bucket of the game, her first trifecta, and it's a 14-point advantage for the Chargers at 28-14. Payne fires it down low to Katie. A little too hot of a pass right there as it went through the fingertips of Spiegel and turned over to CBU. Lytle down to the baseline. Maneuvers it into the corner. Ends up in the hands of Atkins. Right wing it goes. Now attacking the baseline. A wide open three in the corner is good. Wow. Excellent ball movement on that trip down the floor there for the Lady Buccaneers. And the lead shrinks to 11 after that three ball of Eagles. Sanders drives it into the free throw line. Kick it out to Bailey for an open three ball. It is good. Bailey Johnson. Let's feed five, shall we? Because she's eaten so far here this Saturday afternoon. That is her fourth made three of the game. And for Bailey, she is now 4 of 6 from beyond the arc. Driving it again. Buccaneers kick it out top of the key. That's Lytle. Her layup rolls in. Back-to-back buckets for Lytle. It's a 31-19 game now for UAH. Harris gets stopped in the far corner. Ends up in Sanders' hands. Bailey thought about a three, and why not? Spiegel left open underneath, lays it up and in. Easy bucket there for the Austin High graduate. Quickly back with it, one dribble and powering her way up. Stolen away and blocked away by Katie Spiegel. Sanders quickly back with it. Her layup drill rattles in. Sanders now with 8 of the Chargers' 35. It is 35-19. Let's listen to the pep band while we get a chance here in this media break. Actually, the UAH cheerleaders will be featured on this timeout. So a quick word from Coca-Cola.
Best tailgate? It's got to be burgers.
And an ice-cold Coke.
Real football y pollo asado.
Hoops and wings.
Dude, subs.
Nah, hot dog.
No, Dodger dog.
I'll drink to that. Pass me a Coke.
It's got to be crawfish.
Mac and cheese.
No. Seven-layer dip.
Ribs. No contest.
Hummus.
What?
You need a hot grill.
An ice-cold Coke.
Of course.
Football and Coke. Come on.
It's got to be Coke.
Game day? Race day.
Calls for Coke.
You know it.
It's tailgate 101.
97.7 The Zone.
Well, so far in this second quarter, it is a 9-8 game in favor of UAH. But that first quarter of 26-11, a big difference maker to this point. Had a lead of at one time 17 in this game. Right on that fringe at 16 right now. It's a 35-19 game. Buccaneer basketball as they'll walk it up. Under 6 minutes left to go before halftime. Holding it there on the left wing. Now top of the key with it is Atkins, losing the handle and out of bounds to UAH. Turnover number 4 for Christian Brothers. Johnson brings it up. Bailey's made 4 threes in this first half. Bolton to Bailey. Far corner to Emmeline, who walks the tightrope. Shuffles it over to Tipton, who lays it up and in. Morgan Tipton. Third made bucket of the opening half. It's a 27-19 lead now for the UAH Chargers. 18-point lead is now our largest of the game. 5:11 left to go before halftime. Atkins pivots around and kicks it up top of the key. Atkins drives it, scoops it, blocked away by Morgan Tipton, and they're going to say out of bounds off of CBU. Things are rolling the right way for the Chargers here in this first half. Selena Pruitt into the game. Pruitt sends it over to Emmeline Payne, who crosses the timeline. Payne dribbles it out on the left wing. Pruitt to Bolton, back to Pruitt. 10 on the shot clock. Bolton, 3-ball, hits hard off the end of the iron. Rebounded by CBU. 4.5 minutes left to go before halftime. Had a conversation with head coach Lenny Acuff yesterday. I'll play that coming up at halftime here. Layup is good. Count the bucket for Lee. And she powered her way up to the rim through the lane. We'll get the and one opportunity after that foul by Willoughby. The and one for Lee is up and good. She has 6 of CBU's 22. It's a 37-22 lead. Full court press again for the Buccaneers. Payne drives right out of it herself. All the way in, free throw line jumper, banks in! Payne using the friendly square on that backboard. Layup on the other end, a bit wild and rebounded by CBU. Kick it out for a 3-ball. It's good. Wow. Inkos' second made 3 of this first half. It's a 39-25 Charger lead. Willoughby, 3-ball, doinks off the rim. Rebounded by Bolton. Lays it up and in. Allie Bolton's first made bucket of the game, the senior from Smyrna, Tennessee. It's a 41-25 at Charger advantage at the 3:33 mark of quarter number two. Buccaneers step back, a long three on the right wing, no good. Rebounded by Willoughby. Chargers with possession and a lead of 41-25 as we're winding down this first half of action. Bolton to Willoughby. Down low to Tipton, and she walked with the basketball. Tough one right there. That is our fifth turnover of the game. Check that, our sixth turnover of the game. As we tick it, under 3 minutes left to go here in this first half. Driving it, and she either walked with it but misses the layup anyway for Jones, and rebounded by UIH. Looked like she dragged the pivot foot. Pruitt dribbles it out. Sends it over to Payne. A whistle away from the basketball, and a 3 second lane violation is the call. 2:37 to go, and Bailey Johnson checks back in. Harris will check back in on the next dead ball for UIH. Buccaneer basketball, though, as they trail it 41-25. Nice cutter underneath. The layup is good for Lee. Cut right through the lane, caught us napping, and lays it up and in. It's a 41-27 game. Miller left open, misses the three ball as it is volleyballed over to a Buccaneer, and here comes CBU. Back we go in the other direction. We are now scoreless in our last 93 seconds of play are the Chargers. Scoop layup rattles in for CBU, so here come the Buccaneers, although it's a 41-29 Charger advantage here late second quarter. Miller holds it high, skips it into the corner to Johnson for a three ball. No good, and rebounded by CBU. Ball's nearly thrown away, is thrown away, and stolen away by Bailey Johnson. So we're now scoreless in the last 2:08 of play. Maintaining a lead of 41-29. We've led this by as much as 18 so far in this first half. Payne powers her way up. Layup wouldn't have counted anyway. And she will head to the free throw line for two. Katie about to come in, as is Aaron Sanders. My apologies on that. Front end of the free throw is no good. Second free throw is good for Payne. She has three. And right so far, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different Chargers who've scored already in this first half. A 42-point half for UAH with still a minute left to go before halftime. CBU basketball driving it around the arc. There is Jones. Bounces it over to Owen. Near corner, back it goes to Lee. 8 on the shot clock. Baseline layup is good. Count the bucket. Jones fouled on her way up. And what was a bump right at the top of that jump. So the lead is 11 as CBU is hanging around after what has been a pretty efficient half for these ladies. We are shooting 58% from the floor, and we're only up by 10. Full court press. Pruitt will try to drive through it herself, and she's able to do so. Pruitt on the right wing kicks it out. Miller, open three, missed badly, and a layup is partially blocked. A stick back scooped away. Layup is finally rattled in by Katie Spiegel. Lead grows back up to 12. That was our third different look on that one trip down the floor. Backdoor pass is there. Draws a double team. Kick it out. Open three. Rims out. A loose ball foul on Pruitt. will maintain possession for CBU. 17 seconds to go before halftime. It's a 44-32 Charger lead. Inbounds it goes. Driving it to the baseline, powering her way up, a late whistle. I mean, there was some tape on that whistle or something, or not good airflow from the official. But Jones will head to the free throw line off of that late, late whistle. The and one rims out, excuse me, two free throws. She missed the layup. So she'll get one more. Second free throw rattles in. She has four. 13 seconds to go before halftime. Pruitt brings it up. The lead is 11. Sanders to Harris. 8 seconds. Pruitt to Sanders. Open three. No good. Rebounded by Spiegel. At the buzzer, it's good, but they're going to wave away the bucket. Say it didn't count. We're at halftime. Let's listen to the pep band, shall we? I had an opportunity to speak with Coach Lenny Acuff, and here is that conversation.
Countdown to tip-off here with head coach Lenny Acuff. It is senior day as we welcome in Christian Brothers. Congratulations on the win over Montevallo. That was a pretty efficient first half there, Coach.
Yeah, you know, we played really well. The thing that a lot of people talk about is how we shot the ball, and we did shoot it extremely well. But the reason we're able to get those shots was our ball movement, our player movement, and our decision making was really good. I was really proud of the guys, the way they came locked in and ready to go. It would have been easy to overlook that game, but our guys didn't do that. And I was real pleased with just the intensity, the energy, and the focus we came out with.
Another 20-win season, and I know that number is just so important in terms of success and how successful you are, and you're at another 20-win season.
Well, you know, 20 wins in basketball is kind of the somewhat of a holy grail of, okay, have you had a successful winning season? Or that's a lot of people look at that. I'm really proud of the consistency we've had. I guess it's our eighth 20-win season in the last 10 years. But, you know, I think there's a lot of ways you can be successful, and it's not necessarily all just winning games. And I think that that's a piece of the success here. I think the greatest successes we have are the kids we've coached and the guys that have come through our program, what they're doing now. And I don't mean that to be deeper than it needs to be, but I don't think that can be your only barometer of success. You know, I thought last year we had three amazing seniors, and Justin and Kip and Chase, and, you know, we didn't have the kind of year we wanted, but that didn't diminish how I see them. And so, yeah, on the floor, those are tangible things that you look at. And I was excited, you know, for our two seniors, Tanner and Elijah, who will be having senior day today, to be able to put their senior year that have that 20-win mark is something that's a very tangible on the floor accomplishment that you look at. So, but I guess as much as anything, I think the consistency of our program is something that I take a lot of pride in, and you know, makes you feel good about what you're trying to do.
Well, that leads right into senior day. Let's start with Elijah, and really what you've seen. Both of these seniors have been here for the full duration, yeah. But Elijah, what have you seen growth wise out of E?
Well, you know, when you say duration here, it's usually 5 years because you know the majority of our guys redshirt, and you know, I've coached a lot of great kids, a lot of really neat kids. And I can tell you right now, Elijah Garrison is as good as anyone I've ever coached. I think so highly of him. Have so much respect for him. Hold him in the highest regard. He's been raised by amazing parents. They did a great job with he and his sister. And he's just been a blessing since the day he's walked on campus, and really, really seen a maturity in him in the last 18 months or so that I think is pretty substantial. I mean, he's just really grown up, and, you know, he's like every kid. I mean, they come here and they want to play a lot, and there's nothing wrong with that. But it works out sometimes for some kids, and there's others it doesn't. But, you know, he's never changed in who he was. He never treated me any differently. He's been an amazing teammate. He's actually doing an internship for us in our office this summer. That's how much we think of him. And, you know, he kind of came at a difficult time where we just had a lot of good players here, and there's been times that it would have been teams we had many years ago, a few years ago, that he would have been able to play on and had opportunities to play more. But that doesn't, I mean, his career will not be defined by how many minutes he played. You know, your life and is defined by who you impact and how you impact people, and his impact has been substantial here.
Tanner Finley, we've seen significant growth as well, but another local kid coming through and making his mark on this program.
Yeah, Tanner, I saw him today, and I said, man, you're just showing off now. He's took it up a notch, you know. Kind of become a social media star with all this dunking and carrying on. And he's an awesome kid. He's just like Elijah's, just really been raised the right way. Really supportive parents, and just he's worked to be a good player, and he's really turned into a very good player. And you know, he's gonna probably end up averaging 8, 9, 10 points, whatever it is, but he does so many things to affect the game without scoring. And you know, he's really a glue guy for us. He's been that way for the last 2 years. You know, he kind of burst on his scene his freshman year with that 3-point shooting, which was fantastic. But then he's become a lot more than just a shooter. He's long. He's athletic. He's instinctive defensively. He can move his feet. Guarding is really important to him. We feel confident putting him on a good player that he can handle him. You know, he rebounds the ball. He's more athletic than most people realize. And he's just turned into a really all-around good player. And when we first got him, he was just more of a catch-and-shoot guy, and that was kind of his role in high school, but he's evolved to more than that. And but his evolution as a player pales in comparison to his evolution as a person. You know, he's been an amazing leader for us the last year. Since we finished up, you know, he came to me and he said, Coach, I'm on whatever you need me to do, Elijah and I want to do. And he was the guy that organized pickup in the summer. He's the guy that makes sure that we're doing what we're supposed to be doing away from here. He and Elijah both created a tremendous moral fiber in our locker room. They're a great moral compass there. And he and Elijah are a huge part of our success. And both those guys are guys that have huge, huge upsides in their future, and I'm excited to see what God's got in store for them.
Well, a big one here with CBU, and in my world on the broadcasting side, we like to point out like maybe a point or two of a turning point. And the last time we took them on, it was a 2-3 league record coming off arguably our worst loss at Union. And what
out by Union, and we were hurting, you know, we were struggling,
heavily,
and, you know, we had our hand
between
our tail, you know.
Quite honestly, basketball has a good amount of
play, and obviously they're a fantastic team and really well coached. There's no one I respect more than Mike Kneenaber in coaching, and they, you know, have a great player in D-ball and Larrabee and a lot of great other guys, a supporting cast. And we played really well. You know, that was very much a game that kind of jump-started us back in the right direction. And since we went there, we're 9-2 or 10-2, and the two losses we have are last play of the game to West Alabama. But that game means nothing today. You know, all it is going to be more motivation for them. And we're going to get a really good Christian Brothers team today that'll be very well prepared and ready to play, that's for sure. You know, they're so skilled offensively, they're so efficient offensively. They I think they lead the country in first or second in the country in points per possession, which is your offensive efficiency. And you know, D-ball is probably the most well-rounded big kid in the country. You know, he leads our league in assists at the five spot for them. He makes threes, he scores it around the goal, and he's done it for 4 years. And then Larrabee is going to be an all-conference guy for them. And, you know, he's number 11, and he's gone through a stretch where he's averaged almost 30 points a game since we played them. And so it's a huge game for both teams. I'm not going to say you look at the conference standings first, then you look at the regional rankings. There's a lot on the line, but you can't get caught up in that. You know, we just need to play well. We need to be who we are.
Well, I think, Coach, at least through the season of definitions of this team, I immediately think defense.
Yeah, this has been our best defensive group we've had in a long time, if not ever. We went through a stretch where I thought teams were making shots, and I'd be discouraged, and I'd come back and watch, and I'm like, well, that's just tough shot. And there became a little bit of a correction to that, and we just kept guarding, and our guys do play really hard. They want to guard. They want to be good defensively. They're committed to it. They've bought into it, and it's really shown up in our win-loss total and our quality of play.
The other factor I would say is valuing the basketball. Seth in particular, 9 assists, 1 turnover, and the Thursday win.
Yeah, our guard play's been good all year. Seth and Sam have had outstanding years. Really, really good players. And you know, they play winning basketball, and last night was a good example of that. And I don't think either one of them really care how many points they score. They just want us to play well. But the thing is, we need them to score and play well for us to play well. Mm-hmm. And you know, as young guys, they were fortunate last year. They got a lot of opportunities and experience. And you know, it seems like they've both been here a while, and they still have 2 years left. So that's a good thing for us. But they both have had really good years. And you know, we've had, you know, David Anderson's played well for us off the bench. You know, Malik has had a good year for us, and Max Schulman's had a fantastic year for us off the bench. So we've had good guard depth. We've had other guys that have stepped up, but those two guys have for sure been the ringleaders.
Tell me a key or two for a win.
Well, you got to control D-ball. You know, you got to do a good job on him. Not just him scoring points, but his assists. You know, he just throws guys open. He's like Tom Brady. You know, he just throws them open. And for us, we're gonna have to do a good job on him. I think we've got to win that 3-point line against them. If they make 14, 15 threes, you're not winning, and they're gonna shoot them, and they're gonna make their fair share. We just got to make sure they're tough. And then, you know, just not getting caught up in everything that's on the line. Just play. You know, we need to play confident. We don't need to play not to lose. We need to play to go. We need to play to win. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to come out guns blazing, and you know, hopefully we figure out a way. This is absolutely a day where you just try to figure out how to score one more than them. That's the theme of the day, I promise you.
It should be a fun atmosphere, and I know players get to earn this right, and it feels like a gigantic game.
Yeah, you do. We say that all the time. You have to earn the right to play in big games, and our guys have done that. They're going to get to play in big games for the next 2 weeks and hopefully 3 weeks, and I'm excited for them. I'm pulling hard for them, and they deserve all the success that has come their way, and they've been a lot of fun to coach, a lot of fun to be around, and, you know, we know the future's really bright, but we future's now. You know, we need to make it happen.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you. You got it?
Yes, sir. Senior profile, Tanner Finley. Tanner, tell me a little bit about the journey here to UAH and overall your experience here at UAH.
Well, 5 years ago, you know, senior year of high school, I knew that I wanted to play basketball in college and, you know, was just hoping for an opportunity, was just hoping for, you know, some kind of offer, some kind of, you know, you can come play for us. And, you know, really UAH was the only school that extended that offer to me. And, you know, I'm eternally grateful to Coach Acuff and, you know, everybody that's here and, you know, for allowing me to be a part of this special, special program. And, you know, I try not to take it for granted. You know, every single day I try to wake up and work as hard as I can, you know, just for Coach Acuff and this program. And, you know, my 5 years here have been just spectacular. You know, it's probably, you know, more than anything I could have ever imagined. And it's just something that, you know, I'll always cherish. I'll always have these memories. I'll always have these relationships with these coaches and these teammates. And, you know, it's just something that I'll carry with me for the rest of my life. So it's been a really fun, really awesome experience here. And, you know, I hate that my playing days are over, but, you know, I'll always be, you know, be a part of this special program. So
that is a portion of the conversation I had with Tanner Finley. We'll play both full interviews from Tanner Finley and the birthday boy Elijah Garrison. It is his birthday today, and it happens here on senior day for Elijah Garrison. We're at halftime here
Chargers lead it 44-33 here at halftime. Over Christian Brothers, other scores going on around the Gulf South Conference. On the women's side, West Georgia leads it over Lee. Only 6 seconds left to go in the game, 72-67. How does that impact us? Well, West Georgia is right on our heels. This would make West Georgia 10-9 in league play. A win here today for us would make us 11-8. So Thursday would loom even larger with a potential tiebreaker situation there against West Georgia. Women were winners over West Georgia here back in early December. But the other women's game going on has Montevallo with an 8-point lead at halftime over West Florida. 28-20, your score there. Other matchups in the Gulf South Conference has Shorter at Lee Montgomery. And Mississippi College is at Delta State. Ten more minutes goes up on the clock. Third quarter action here on UAHChargers.com. Glad to have you along for the YouTube video as well as on 97.7thezone.com. You can listen to 97.7 over the airwaves at 97.7 on your FM dial. Glad to have you along, however you may be listening here this Saturday afternoon. Bailey Johnson to plug it in. Chargers go right to left across your radio dial here in this second half. It's an 11-point Charger lead. Johnson pivots, kicks it out to Miller. Bolton back to Miller, sends it over to Sanders, who attacks the baseline, finds Tipton, one bounce, lays it up and in. Morgan Tipton, who had 6 first half points, first second half point, and it's now a 13-point Charger advantage. Backdoor pass is stolen away by Sanders, but unable to keep it in play is Aaron, but good hustle there. Stays CBU basketball with 19 on the shot clock. Inbounds it goes. Kick it into the far corner. Jones drives it in, kicks it up top of the key, holding it Lytle. 8 on the shot clock. 5 on the shot clock, driving it, scooping it, wide open layup drill that time. Someone blew an assignment there defensively for the wide open lay-in, and the lead is now at 11. Miller resets it. Swings it over right wing, and it's popped away and stolen away, and now it ends up on the deck, and a timeout is granted to UIH. A 46-35 lead for the UIH Chargers at the 8:43 mark. So we'll take a pause and a quick word from Coca-Cola.
Best tailgate? It's got to be burgers.
And an ice-cold Coke.
Real football. Y pollo asado.
Hoops. And wait.
Chips. Subs.
Nah. Hot dog.
No. Dodger dog.
I'll drink to that. Pass me a Coke.
It's got to be crawfish.
Mac and cheese.
No. Seven-layer dip.
Ribs. No contest.
Hummus.
What?
You need a hot grill.
And an ice-cold Coke.
Of course.
Football and Coke. Come on.
It's got to be Coke.
Game day? Race day.
Calls for Coke.
You know it.
It's tailgate 101.
97.7 The Zone.
8:43 left to go here in quarter number 3. Chargers led it 26-11 after the first quarter and 44-33 at halftime. We have just started second half action here. We'll have coverage of the men as well right here. The regional rankings came out on Wednesday, and the Chargers came out 7th, Christian Brothers 8th, in the men's rankings. So a rather large game here on Senior Day, frankly, for both squads, the men and women. West Georgia was winners. I assume they won. Let me see if I can pull that up. That is a final. West Georgia is a winner. Sanders drives it. Sanders scoops it. Sanders misses the layup. Rebounded by Tipton. She'll lay it up and no good. Rebounded by CBU. So now West Georgia with a half game behind us. One game in the loss column. Three ball is good. Top of the key for Lee. The senior from Jackson, Tennessee, makes it a single-digit lead. The lead is down to eight. At one point in the first half, we led this thing, I believe, by 18. We did at 37-19. Sanders, three ball, no good. Rebound is loose, taken out by CBU. So we shot in the first half 58% from the floor. Excuse me. No, it's 52% from the floor. A foul underneath stops the action. That sends sends UAH to the free throw line. 46-38 your score. Sanders, free throw. Good. She has nine in the game, the junior from Signal Mountain, Tennessee. Second free throw. Good. Back up to a double-digit lead at the 7:33 mark of quarter number three. 48-38. Holding it there on the wing, Lytle. Long three and an open look. Rims out for Lee and out of bounds off of Sanders, so it will be CBU basketball. Emmeline Payne is in, as is Holly Harris is in. Long look. Inbounds it goes in the far corner. Attacking the baseline. Baseline jumper. No good that time by Taylor, and a loose ball foul on CBU. It's a 10-point Charger advantage. The lead was 11 at halftime. The lead was 15 at the end of the first quarter. We had 26 points in the first quarter. Harris starts off the dribble, resets it to Payne, and she threw it away. Stolen away by CBU. They'll reset it. Open three look is good as it rattles home for Lee. Her second made three of this third quarter, and she now has 14 in the game. It's a 7-point Charger lead at 48-41. Bailey tries to answer, unable to do so. Rebounded though by Sanders. Fresh shot clock so we can reset our offense. Harris, contested three balls, no good. Rebounded by CBU. It's a 48-41 lead. We're now one out of our last seven. Another three, another make for Lee. And a timeout on the floor. 6:10 left to go. A lead that was once 18 is now down to four at 48-44. little bit of the UIH pep band for you. 48-44. Christian Brothers has outscored us in this third quarter, 11-4. Full court press for CBU. Inbounds it goes to Sanders in the backcourt. Skips it up ahead to Payne. Nicely done up to Harris. Harris drives it, scoops it, reverse layup, no good. Rebounded by CBU. We're now 1 of 7 here in this third quarter. Another three, this time a miss for CBU. Rebounded by Holly Harris. Harris back with it. Sanders open three ball, banks in, and just kind of puts her palms up in the air. I'll take it any way we can get it, Aaron. 51-44, a much needed bucket right there. Boy, Cutter looked like she was wide open. Holding it on the wing now is Lee. She'll drive it, lose the handle. She either was walked or was fouled. And Payne, guilty of the foul. Her first foul. First team foul of the third quarter. Cutter is there. Layup is blocked away by Morgan Tipton. Payne back with it. Payne dribbles it out. Sends it over to Sanders. Down low to Moe. Spins, scoops, and scores. Morgan Tipton's second made bucket of the third quarter. Lead grows back up to 9 after it was once 4. A nice little mini run here for the Chargers on the last two possessions. Cutter is there again. Lee lays it up and in. So that is the second time that Lee was really open there in the lane. Sanders drives it. Sanders fouled on her way up. Lays it up and in. Count the bucket. Fouled on her way up is Aaron. She'll get the and one opportunity. Lead back up to 9. Like to welcome those of you that have been following or listening to the West Georgia game. After West Georgia, a winner over Lee, 74-69. Free throw on the and one is good there for Sanders. The Chargers have led this thing by as much as 18. But Lee just cut it to 4, but we have answered it back up to a 10-point lead. Three ball, no good. Rebounded, though, by CBU. Driving it down to the baseline. It's out of bounds off of Bailey Johnson. 25 on the shot clocks. 4:17 left to go in this third quarter. Inbounds it goes. Holding it on the wing, there's Jones. Man-to-man defense for the Chargers. Open three for Lee. Rattles in. Rachel Lee, that is her fourth made three of the quarter. She is on a hot streak. Payne drives it and is fouled on her way up. It is amazing the kind of streak that Lee is on. She is now 5 of 7 from beyond the arc, but 4 of those 5 made threes are here in this third quarter alone. Front end of the free throws, good for Payne. She'll get one more. She makes both. CBU's able to bring it back in what is now a 9-point advantage for the Chargers. After 2 made free throws, layup is good. Count the bucket for Jones. So the lead shrinks to 7 again at 58-51 and an and-one opportunity After a foul on Bailey Johnson, the late free throw's no good and rebounded by Bailey. Sanders holds it high, skips it over to Harris, bounce pass to Katie, who lays it up and in. Well executed right there, tic-tac-toe. Lead grows back up to 9, 60-51. Another three. This one is missed by Rachel Lee. She wasn't in her exact spot. She was back by about a half a foot. And that equals a miss. 60-51, Chargers with the lead and the basketball. Payne hesitates, bounces it to Katie, ends up on the deck, and a timeout is taken by CBU, and they will own possession of this basketball with 3:03 to go in the third quarter, down by 9 here in Huntsville. A little more of the pep band. To 51, your score. Chargers maintain the lead, but Christian Brothers chipping away. They've outscored us in this third quarter, 18-16. Buccaneer basketball. That's Atkins with it. Sends it into the near corner. Atkins again with it, drives it. Her reverse layup, no good. Nice defense by Katie Spiegel. Sanders to the other end, lays it up, high off the glass, no good. Rebounded, though, by Harris in some traffic. Kicks it into the near corner. 18 on the shot clock. Did that not hit the rim? I guess it didn't. Harris drives it hard to the baseline. I thought it did. Sanders with 5 on the shot clock. Sanders with 4 on the shot clock. Drives it, forces the layup, no good. That certainly hit the rim, and rebounded by CBU. 2:08 to go. The lead is 9 for the UAH Chargers. Atkins again with it. Pivots around. Creates some space. Sends it into the near corner. Holding it is Lee. Lee either walked with it or was fouled, and she was bumped by Payne. Second foul for Emmeline Payne. CBU to plug it into play with a fresh shot clock. Driving it hard to the baseline. Layup is no good, but a walking violation anyway by Jones will give possession to the Chargers. 8th turnover of the game for CBU. Harris starts off her dribble, fires it over to Sanders, who kind of wound her way through some traffic and lays it up and in. Stopping and popping at the elbow is good. There for Jones, her second made bucket of the third quarter. It's a 9-point Charger lead at 62-53 as CBU just hangs around here in Huntsville. Payne drives it in, kicks it over to Sanders. She'll reset it with 12 on the shot clock. Pruitt to Harris to Sanders for a 3-ball. No good. Long rebound goes to CBU. Running with it, Lytle. Lytle drives it, lays it up and in. So it's 62-55 now. Back-to-back quarters now in which CBU has scored 22 points in the second and now the third quarter. Payne thought about a three. drives, it gets bumped. We have scored 18 points in the second quarter, and so far that is what we have scored here in the third quarter. Payne to the free throw line. We had 26 in the first quarter. CBU had 11 in the first quarter. Front end of the free throws, no good there for Payne. Emmeline's now 3 of 6 from the free throw line. Second free throw, no good as well. Down to 30 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Cross-court pass stolen away by Sanders. Layup drill is up and no good. Rebounded by CBU. Oh, mercy. Buccaneer ball. Bounce pass down low. Scoop layup rolls in for Atkins. Boy, those missed layups. That is 6 now for Atkins. 62-57. Pruitt with 2 seconds. Pruitt heaves it up and makes the jumper right at the buzzer for Pruitt. Her first made bucket of the game. The freshman from Memphis, Tennessee, of all places. 64-57. Chargers hold the advantage as we head to the fourth quarter.
In Alabama, sports matter. They break down barriers and bring people together. Sports help make us who we are. It's in our blood, our culture, and our hearts. Because your team isn't just your team, it's your family. And that's why Blue Cross is a proud sponsor of athletic programs across the state. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama. We cover what matters.
Ever have one of those days when nothing seems to go your way? Maybe instead of that sad breakfast bar you ate this morning, you should have started your day off right with a made-from-scratch breakfast biscuit from Bojangles. Don't worry, it's never too late to restart your day at Bojangles. Our delicious breakfast biscuits are served for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, so you can get your day back on track anytime. Go ahead, come into Bojangles and restart your day with 2 country ham biscuits for just $3.69. Bojangles, it's bow time.
97.7, The Zone.
Ten more minutes up on the clock. More folks continue to stream in. Here inside the stable. Driving it, scooping it, scoring it there is Lytle. Second made bucket of the second half. It's just a 5-point lead now at 64-59. Miller starts off her dribble, kicks it out to Payne. Bailey kicks it up top of the key. That's to Miller. Her pass is stolen away by CBU. Dribbling it out there is Jones. Driving it, scooping it, laying it up too hard off the glass that time for Lee and rebounded by Bailey Johnson. Bailey back with it, hesitates, drives it, bumped on the floor. 2 shots, though, awarded to Bailey Johnson, who was red hot early. Bailey, the senior, had 12 first half points. Front end, rims in for Bailey. Her first point of the second half, and she now has 13 in the game. Second free throw, rims in. It's a 66-59 advantage with 9:05 to play here in Huntsville. Buccaneer ball, driving it into the elbow. Backing her way in, pivoting it around there is Jones. Kicks it back out top of the key. Wide open three. Wouldn't have counted anyway as an offensive charge was taken underneath by a Charger defender. Lytle with the foul and a key. key stop there defensively and a chance to grow the lead here for UAH. Payne drives it into the elbow, into a double team, stops her dribble. Pruitt, open three, rims out, no good. Rebounded by CBU. Got to be careful of those elbows. Driving it, scooping it, laying it up, no good. Is Lytle, but she had enough of a bump on her way up to head to the free throw line. In between games, my conversations with the two Charger senior men. But certainly congratulations to Morgan Tipton, Bailey Johnson, Allie Bolton, Heidi Miller, seniors on this women's team that are fighting for a spot in the Gulf South Conference basketball tournament. So two made free throws right there has made it a 66-61 game. Bolton skips it over. Payne looking for Tipton underneath, but she's covered up. Bailey drives it with eight on the shot clock. Five on the shot clock. That's Payne to Bolton. A long three. No good. Rebounded by CBU. 66-61. CBU again just hanging around. Holding it, Lee, top of the key. Pivoting it around there is Atkins. Back to Lee, who drives it, lays it up and in. Lee had eight at halftime. She now has 24 in the game. The lead is cut to three, 66-63. CBU has never led this game. Tipton loses the handle off of a lot of hot sauce on that pass. The lead is a tenuous three right now at 66-63. Driving it, little floater, too hard off the glass, and a loose ball foul on Atkins, I believe. Charger basketball, 66-63. We have been scoreless throughout the last 2:21 of this fourth quarter. We have not been this close since early in the first quarter. And I mean early in the first quarter because we started out awfully hot. Sanders to bring it up. Under 7 minutes left to go. How many West Georgia fans are tuning in right now? Harris drives it, stops and pops, misses it, rebounded by Bolton. The senior lays it up and in. Allie Bolton on senior day. Second made bucket. Big bucket right there, and it's a 68-63 advantage. Cutter again is there. Layup is no good, but bumped on her way up is Rachel Lee. Buccaneers have ran that play at least three different times this second half, and it's been open every time for Rachel Lee. Cutting right through that far side of the lane. Free throw is good. She is a senior out of Jackson, Tennessee, is Rachel Lee. She'll get one more free throw. The lead is four. And it rims out, no good. The lead stands at four, 68-64. Sanders sends it up ahead to Pruitt. Bolton holds it, finds Tipton in the near corner. Bolton again with 12 on the shot clock. Finds Harris, open three, rains it in. Holly Harris left open, makes him pay. That's her first bucket of the game. And it's a 71-64 lead. Forcing the layup and the issue. There was Jones. She missed the layup. Sanders left open. Lays it up, no good. And it's tipped out of bounds to Christian Brothers. In fact, a foul is called on Tipton, her third foul. 71-64. So CBU has been within four and now just most recently within three. But we keep answering. Lee holds it top of the key. Now she'll drive it, scoop it, lay it up and in. Rachel Lee is having a heck of a second half. 19 of her 27 have been scored here in this second half. 5:05 to play. Sanders skips it over to Bolton, down low to Tipton. Attacks the lane, back out to Sanders, open three is good! Erin Sanders, her fourth made three of the game. Lead grows back up to eight at the 4:44 mark of quarter number four. Driving it, scooping it, scoring it again is Rachel Lee. Wow. She now has 29 of the Buccaneers' 68. Keeping CBU in the neighborhood. Harris starts off the dribble. Ends up in Tipton's hands. Back to Harris, another three. Another make for Holly Harris. Lead grows up to nine, courtesy of the freshman, Holly Harris. Open three for Atkins. Rims out, rebounded by Pruitt. Pruitt back up with it, fires it up ahead to Sanders, who attacks it. Harris, no way! Three in a row for number 12 for Holly Harris. And it's a 12-point advantage at 80-68. Holly Harris, ladies and gentlemen.
Tailgate, it's gotta be burgers.
And an ice cold Coke.
Real football y pollo asado.
Hoops and wait.
Chips. Subs.
Nah, hot dog.
No, Dodger dog.
I'll drink to that. Pass me a Coke.
It's gotta be crawfish.
Mac and cheese.
No, seven layer dip.
Ribs.
No contest.
Hummus.
What?
You need a hot grill.
An ice cold Coke.
Of course.
Football and Coke, come on.
It's got to be Coke.
Game day, race day.
Calls for Coke, you know it.
It's Tailgate 101.
97.7, The Zone.
Holly Harris, the freshman out of Franklin, Tennessee, from Franklin High School, with some big buckets here down the stretch. I wish I could go through the play-by-play chart. I want to say this was a 68-66 game. Or is, let's see if I can't roll it back. 68-64. It was a 66-63 lead at the 7:32 mark. The Buccaneers have scored 5 points since that time. And it is now 80-68. CBU basketball, 3:40 left to play. Atkins pivots around, that's Spiegel on her defensively. Sends it down low, back to the bucket this time for Lee. Backdoor cutter is there again and the layup is good again. Wow, that backdoor is left wide open so far here in this second half. Lead is at 10 as we roll into some four corners action. Pruitt into the elbow. Kicks it out to Sanders underneath the Spiegel. Skip it out over the head of Pruitt and out of bounds to CBU. 3:04 to play. The lead is 10. Buccaneers bring it up. Move it around the arc. Ends up in the hands of Lytle. Now Atkins pivots around with it. Ball nearly stolen away and just saved in play by Lytle. So close for Aaron Sanders. Into the near corner. Atkins walked with the basketball before she started her dribble on the left hand. Bailey Johnson set the check in and will do so for Pruitt. So the senior back in on senior day with a 10-point lead. Trying to get into the Gulf South Conference basketball tournament. Sanders to Bolton. Bolton finds Spiegel. Skip it out. Open three. The senior Bailey rattles in for Bailey Johnson. Her first made bucket of the second half. Lead grows to 13. Up with it, Jones. Kicks it into the far corner. Lytle resets it with 12 on the shot clock. Resetting it to Lytle. 8 on the shot clock. Driving it in. The scoop layup on the layup drill is good. And a timeout by CBU. An 11-point lead for the Chargers here with a minute 54 to play. It is 83-72 here on the campus of UAH.
In Alabama, sports matter. They break down barriers and bring people together. Sports help make us who we are. It's in our blood, our culture, and our hearts. Because your team isn't just your team. It's your family. And that's why Blue Cross is a proud sponsor of athletic programs across the state. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama. We cover what matters.
Ever have one of those days when nothing seems to go your way? Maybe instead of that sad breakfast bar you ate this morning, you should have started your day off right with a made-from-scratch breakfast biscuit from Bojangles. Don't worry, it's never too late to restart your day at Bojangles. Our delicious breakfast biscuits are served for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, so you can get your day back on track anytime. Go ahead, come into Bojangles and restart your day with two country ham biscuits for just $3.69. Bojangles, it's bow time.
97.7, The Zone.
CBU held a very early lead of 4-3. Then the Chargers outscored CBU in the first quarter 26-11. And now lead it 83-72. Minute 48 and counting left to go. Harris dribbles it out at midcourt. Finds Bailey Johnson. Johnson picks it up in the backcourt as it was tipped into the backcourt. Harris drives it. Harris loses the handle. Saved. Nope, not saved in play. Out of bounds to CBU. 99 seconds to play. The lead is 11. Not impossible, but not likely either. It's hard to do unless you've got a long shooter and a three ball. And no good that time for Lee. I mean, when you can only think of really one guy doing it, a guy by the name of Miller, who scored 9 points by himself in a postseason game down with the New York Knicks. Spiegel kicks it out to Bolton, 10 on the shot clock. Bailey drives it, her layup, no good, and out of bounds to CBU. A trip to the Gulf South Conference basketball tournament, 48 seconds away. Top of the key, free throw line jumper, no good, rebounded by UAH. 9-second difference between game clock and shot clock. Harris will dribble it out. And now the senior Bailey Johnson dribbles it out at midcourt. A timeout is taken by UAH with 11 on the shot clock, 20 on the game clock. It is an 83-72 game. And CBU certainly made a run of it in the third and fourth quarter in particular. We have outscored CBU in this fourth quarter 19-15. Congratulations to seniors Morgan Tipton, Bailey Johnson, Allie Bolton, and Heidi Miller here on Senior Day. Heck of a way to get into the Gulf South Conference basketball tournament. Bailey dribbles it out, finds Bolton, and a walking violation on Allie. Turns it over to CBU. 16 seconds to go. Jones brings it up. Holding it, Lee. Bounces it over. 7 seconds to play. Three ball attempt for Atkins. No good. Rebounded by UAH, and that'll do it. 83-72 is your final score to the Gulf South Conference basketball tournament. Go these ladies as they improve to 13-12 and 11-8 in GSC play.
Ladies and gentlemen, with today being the final home game of the regular season, we wanted to